What is going on, guys? We are back with game 2 ulti best of 3 playoffs. Googly vs Fardin, and yeah, Googly won game 1 with this exact same team. So Fardin brought this nice and crispy Zard white team. I think this is the team that my man BTB made, so I can tell you all the sets. This is Ground DMZ Ductria with, I think, Subtoxic and Screech. This is just Scald, Roost, Toxic, Default, Manta. Is that why? I think Hidden Power, Ice, Roost, Flamethrower, and Solar Beam. Maybe instead of Hidden Power, Ice, it was Focus Blast, I don't remember, but I think it was HP Ice. But yeah, Ghoulie has this triple bird pressure stall, he gets an early burn, which sucks. Aww. Let me see if the I don't see how does Fardin break this team. I mean, he can trap the Clefable if he goes in the Duggy here. Yeah, exactly. He can go Duggy. He can now Screech into Ground Zedith. Exactly, and he hits. So Moomba's gonna like 64, okay. So he's gonna Ground Z. Bob the Clefable is gone. But I don't see that why breaking the team really. Yeah, ban, exactly, ban is shit. Yeah, he's just gonna go, dude. He doesn't wanna get poisoned on his birds. He lost his healable user. So poison on his birds, especially on Moltres, a poison would be really bad for Googly, because Moltres is his main mount to check the Zard now, or wall the Zard. Yeah, but he has the Tita to pressure the Moltres, so it's actually not as bad as I thought at first. I forgot about the Tita. Lily is also a threat. It's Scarf Lily though, so it's not that strong. So yeah, he's gonna be able to check Scarf Lily. Articuno is really good spit def, gonna be able to eat some hits. Wait, did he change the set? Was it always reversal? I thought it was toxic. Maybe it was always a reversal. But yeah, he knows that this is Volt Switch in Power Ice, Ruth, and Defog. Unless he changed the set. So he's gonna try to get up hazards to make Googly Defog. Pretty sure this is Rocks, Ferrothorn. This team doesn't have spikes because most of the time you have to defog because there's a Zard Y. So yeah, he's gonna make him defog, I guess, just so the rocks are gone for Zard. Wait, Kanto wants to play versus extra right now, that would be fire, I would be down to record. Somebody's gonna defog here. Oh, maybe he doesn't have defog on this bird. But he has defog on both the other birds, that's what I know. Is Fardin gonna risk his Manta? Is he just gonna go Ferrothorn? Yeah, he doesn't risk his Manta. Default question mark? Roost. But yeah, this is, I don't remember if this has knockoff. But he's either gonna knockoff or leech sheet here. Yeah, they played game 1 on main. If I didn't say it already, I recorded that in a separate video, because I had some recording issues today. Just wanna make sure that everything is safe. I'm already uploading game 1 in the background, that's another reason. Man, it is kinda shitty at the moment. Another reason I cut it off, started a new recording so I can start it uploading, have it up kinda fast. Because I'm super mad that I lost that Smogtris recording that I should've had up. He's just gonna stay in. He has pressure, so he's like stalling the cheat a bit. I mean, I can see that Googly, like, Googly's trying to not defog, but like, and what was that Ruth play? I don't like that Ruth play. Yeah, that's the knockoff. But yeah, this is apparently Z move, because it didn't get knocked off. So it has to be Z Ruth or Z Volt Switch. Or does Z defog do something else? I have no idea what Z move this is. It's some Z move Zapdos. Like, we know that it's either Z Ruth, Z defog, or Z Volt Switch. I think Z-Roost. What does Z-Roost do? Data Roost. Does it say there's Z-effects here? Data Z-Roost, can we look that up? I don't know. I don't remember the effect. Oh, okay, negative effects, negative stats will get rid of and you heal. Just like a regular roost. So Z-Roost is not really that crazy. Maybe it's the Volt Switch to do good damage to certain Pokemon, I'm not really sure. Oh, I know why it's Z-Move. It's its switch in for knockoff. That's ingenious. Gully is on another level. So he can take a knockoff from Bisharp better. It's fire. From knockoff from Bisharp, knockoff from what other Pokemon are common with knockoff? Like Bisharp is not in that common at the moment. I don't know. Yeah, that's kinda cool. I see why he has a Z-Move now. It's probably just for utility, and if he needs it can have the Z-Roost or whatever it is. Maybe it's the Volt Switch for more damage, not sure. So you get rid of the rocks, finally Psychic did a fuckload. Even though there's a Scarf, I think. Yeah, so he's gonna try to poison this. He's gonna go Moltres here, it's his only switch to this. Doubles out on the Mantine, which is a really good play. Unless this has HP Electric. But yeah, he can go for Roost, he get his Mantine healthy. I like that play a lot. Another option would have been doubling into Tita, but this probably has Will-O-Wisp. This could have Will-O-Wisp, yeah. So Tita would have been a really risky there, but yeah, there's also Dougie in the back, so I understand, but you don't want to get Tita. Dougie's always a scummy Pokemon. We have seen it already, it trapped the Clef. So he goes for Toxic. Oof, juicy play. So he's gonna knock here. Yeah. I don't know if I like that play. Letting Mantine get knocked sucks a bit, but it's fine, I guess. The only annoying part, if I record multiple vids or do multiple vids for this, I have to make multiple thumbnails, but it's fine. I enjoy making thumbnails, but like not at 5:50 in the morning, LMAO. I didn't mean to say LMAO. I will explain it in an earlier video why I say things like that. I'm in call with like wild ass people that are stupid wild, like Padlop. They just say that shit. And I get used to it, and sometimes I say it myself then. Like, you don't say that word out like I said it out, you just laugh. That you know what I'm talking about. So that is completely zero. This is a... He can U-turn. Yeah, he can just U-turn here. Get some chip on the Mantine. Oh, he can also roost if he breaks the flamethrower. I didn't think about that fighting could stay in. Yeah, I didn't think that through. It's fine. What's the last move? It's probably Will-O-Wisp, right? Like if he didn't have a Dougie, I would say it's in power ground, but he has a Dougie. So just U-turns on heat-turns, and Volt switches on heat-turns with Zapdos and traps it with Dougie. Unless it's Shed Shell turn. This is Focus Sash, we've already seen that, so it's probably Earthquake, Reversal. Screech, and I was about to say Stone Edge, but it's Rock Tomb. I don't know why he stayed in. He potentially predicted the Pursuit, but I don't really like that play. Because Pursuit wouldn't have killed, I think. So, I don't like that play. What the fuck was that? Huh? But yeah, Lily gets to click Psychic here. I mean, I guess he just said I don't want the Czar, and he was banking on this not having moved. You know, I think he just predicted him to go back into Moltres, I'm not sure. Like, he knew that Moltres was the Czar, but I'm not the biggest fan of that play. Because if you catch the Moltres with your Tita, you can potentially put in some work, but it's still hard. Because if you get the 50-50 wrong with Tita, because if you click Bandit Pursuit on the Moltres and it stays into Whisper, you're fucked. And if you click Stone Edge and he goes Hard Dougie, then he just traps you with Reversal. So yeah, it's kind of tough, but he could have potentially put in work with that if he got it correct the 50s versus the Moltres with the tar. Where Psychic is gonna bounce off. This one has a good spell left, but he gets a drop. Man, if Google actually 2-0 with the bird team, that's crazy. It's still stall though, so it's kind of scummy, but it's a heat-ish stall. And it's 5:50 in the morning. Yeah, my man Sorry is playing in 5 days for ulti. Who else is playing? I forgot. Kanto vs Extras should supposed to be tomorrow, but I'll take it if they would play right now. But they're probably not gonna. Yeah, this Lily basically gets a kill now because you get the Spadef drop on the Arikuna, which sucked. I mean, I see what Ghoulie was doing. He was kind of trying to stall out the psychic terrain, but it lasted too long, so it's gonna get a kill for sure. Zapdos is only at 4%, but Zapdos still has some value because it's one of the few monsters that pressures the Mantine out. I mean, this also pressures Mantine and freeze dry. Yeah, so never mind. He gets crit. I mean, that sucks, but like, he had to sack something anyways. Actually, no, he didn't have to. He could have gone into Dagi. Nah, Dagi would have gone to the Sash and couldn't Oko Lily, never mind. Yeah, he had to sack something, he had to just pick. Don't think that matter too much. But yeah, now you can travel with Dagi if he wants to. Like, Earthquake into Earthquake just kills this. Now that I'll think about it for a bit, this could be max defense to check Mega Heracross because, well, look at this Heracross switch-ins. Maybe this is Aerial Ace as well to Revenge Heracross. We haven't seen the entire moveset yet, I think. Everything is possible. Or maybe he has HP flying on this or something. Actually, no, I don't think. I think he already revealed that this was Freeze Dry Roost Defog. I actually don't know the last move. Maybe it's HP Fly for Hera. Hera is somewhat of a threat for bulky teams like this. So I assume he's just gonna roost up with his Moltres here. As long as he has the... Yeah, that did nothing. As long as he has the Doggy intact, then he's fine. But if he loses his Doggy, Tita has a threat. So I understand why he didn't want to lose his Doggy Focus Sash, actually. So this is kind of nice. He gets the Zapdos healthy. He can just roost. I don't know if Faden is gonna risk this Mantine here and roost. If Google catches him here and Volt switches and the Mantine stays in, it's gonna be bad for Faden. Ferrothorn is a safer play, but I have a feeling that he's gonna roost here. Like, not, it's like kinda obvious, and I don't know what I'm trying to say. It's like, Yeah, he made the, okay. Thought I made the correct play, okay. But this time my feeling was wrong. I had the sauce. I predicted something correct. Just check that out if you didn't see it yet. Yeah, just some juicy flamethrower damage, I assume, yeah. The flamethrower burn on the, I think that he got in the Mantine early, that sucked. But I don't know if it's gonna be like game, but I don't think it's gonna be game changer. So I wanna get a burn. So he's gonna spam Psychic, obviously, is his strongest move. Articuno is, yeah, it's at 30, so he has to sack something. Actually, if he spams Roost, he might be able to eat this. How much did the last Psychic do? 36. So yeah, if he Roost spams, he might be able to stall out the Psychic terrain, because it's only doing with leftovers. It's only doing like 6% or something like that. Yeah, like if he spams Roost, as long as there's no Spadef drop, he can just stall out the Psychic terrain. Wait. Oh my fucking god, I just realized. Why did he click Psychic? Oh my fucking god, I just realized he got pressure stalled. That was ass. I think he should have just clicked Psyshock probably. But I didn't pay attention to his PP. Damn, this pressure stall is like putting the work. Yeah, at 5:50 in the morning, like I said earlier. So like my brain is not gonna work. So I should just scroll over the mods and pay attention better. Hard zap this on the Roost, goat. So he's just gonna Volt Switch spam. Actually, yeah, exactly. The reason why he didn't Roost earlier, I actually get it, because the Tar could potentially come out. I mean, even if the Tar comes out on traps, then the Tar gets trapped by the Doggy. But still, he doesn't lose anything from Volt Switching, just in case the Mantine stays in, yeah. And yeah, this game is a wrap. Googly wins. Whenever Tita comes out, he just has to sack one of his birds to trap it with Duck Trio. Oh, he gets the Roost play. Whew. I mean, not that it's like a super godly play. The Roost was free there, but Voltage was also free. And yeah, I guess having another pressure bird alive helps him just to PP stall. Just gonna defog here. Yeah, the nice pressure ability just helps the defog get more PP than the Stealth Rock. But yeah, that's actually crazy how Googly won 2-0 with this. Like, I'm pretty sure he's gonna win. I mean, he can Crunch or Stone Edge, it doesn't matter. He gets one kill at best. He can even go hard into Duck Trio. Yeah, he can go hard Duck Trio. Because he's gonna get brought onto the session and Reversal just kills the Tita. He doesn't have to go hard Duggy, but he can. It literally doesn't matter. I think he's just gonna go hard Duggy, yeah. Because he doesn't need the Duggy for anything else. Like, Ferrothorn is no threat for him. I mean, Ferro is annoying, but like, it's not gonna do it. Yeah, Ferro's not doing anything. It's just sitting there and clicking rocks on each sheet. So that wasn't a Ferro on the... Oof, fire play. I mean, if he's... Never mind, what am I saying? Actually, did he run enough speed? Yeah, I assume he has enough speed to outspeed Tar anyway. Or maybe does he just naturally outspeed? Yeah, I just don't know speed teams anymore. Like, I don't know anything at 6 a.m. in the morning. Yeah, free flamethrower, Pharaoh's gone. Like, it literally doesn't matter what Googly does. It literally doesn't matter, because at one point he can just sack one of his birds to Tita and then just trap the Tita. So yeah, nice and 2-0 win. Really pulling up with the birds in ulti playoffs, so the birds are gonna be in a thumbnail for sure. Yeah, Farden is still in ulti. I don't know why he thought he was out. I just realized, yeah. Exactly, it's a double elimination. He didn't even notice. What the fuck? He qualified for a tournament and didn't notice. Hope you win this too. My spam store from now. I did not know rules. After qualifying. I mean, I guess he didn't read them. But yeah, Googly 2 out. This fire, Moltres, zap, this Articuno, triple pressure stall in the cut. Some Octopus was a... That was like some super long battle that I recorded, but my recording crashed. But it actually wasn't that... This was at least somewhat exciting because the game didn't take 500 years. Some Octopus game that I recorded was like forever. It took like 2 hours. Yeah, I'm kind of just waiting for this guy to make his win post. Man, that boy just said, hope you win the tournament for a second, that's how he was out, but yeah, obviously it's double elimination. Didn't make a win post yet. But yeah, quite impressive, showing Googly the God pulling through 2-0. And yeah, I have recorded some Smokers, as mentioned in the first part of this OG series. Yeah, I lost the second part. It's kind of sad, but yeah, the first part is gonna go up. Like, I don't know when. Maybe tomorrow, maybe later. I don't know when I'm gonna sleep. I don't know anything anymore. My schedule is completely fucked up. But yeah, Sunday, so 2 days, I'm gooch. Nothing to do. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. At least it was heat stall, not dog sh- weird stall, like gay stall. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Yeah, he brought Wish Kill again, one. That was so weird. I'm basically. Like, I was really hoping that. Exoshen will play with update canon now, but it's gonna be tomorrow, I think. I mean, we can see if there's any battles going on. There's one battle going on. It's just a friendly. But yeah, thank you for watching. And congrats to Googly. I think, is he in winner's bracket now? I don't know exactly how it works. It's just called round one. I think if you win, you're in winner's bracket, but I'm not sure how it works. And yeah, have a fantastic day. Goodbye. Yeah, leave a like if you enjoyed.